How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And today I'm going to be showcasing to you guys one of the best free VPNs you can get on the market today for Windows. So, you know, if you've been looking for free VPNs, you'd notice that a lot of them have some sort of catch. So they might be free, but they might log your info. They might not have enough servers on offer, let's say with the free version. And, you know, most of the times, it's probably not the safest idea to use a free VPN. You're probably better off using a free trial of a legit VPN rather than using a free VPN. But today we have Provado VPN, which is one of those VPNs that are actually quite a bit reliable, even with the free version. Now, before we begin, if you guys are interested in any of the VPNs mentioned today, you'll find links to special deals and discounts in the description down below, as well as full-on reviews if you'd like to know the ins and outs of these VPNs in terms of privacy policy, speed streaming, torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features. So be sure to keep that in mind if you guys are interested. Now, with Provado VPN, you do get 12 servers. So you'll be able to get access to 12 regions, even with the free version. Total regions is 45. You've got 45 regions or 45 countries. And of course, if you didn't know, most VPNs will actually kind of restrict you to a few regions, perhaps one or two, or some of them three countries. But with Provado VPN, you're actually getting quite a few countries, 12 of them. Now, keep in mind, this is the paid version I have, so it has all 45, but with the free version, you'll be getting 12. So more likely than not, you'll be able to get yourself into a proper server, since most free servers will be overloaded, but with 12 countries, you're bound to find a good server. Not just that, you'll be able to use the VPN for 10 gigabytes per month. So let's say, I think this kind of restriction is fair for the most part. If it wasn't restricted, then there would probably be a catch if there wasn't a bandwidth restriction. No VPN is truly free. So what Provado here is trying to do is just trying to give you the opportunity to try out the VPN if you need a VPN to, let's say, secure your data while you're on public Wi-Fi and whatnot, then they're just giving you that chance for as long as 10 gigabytes. Or as much as 10 gigabytes, I guess that would be more accurate. With regards to preferences, there isn't really much with the VPN. You do have a kill switch for security. With protocols, you've got OpenVPN and IKEF2. Scramble will turn on the obfuscation if you're in censorship-heavy countries, which, of course, changes the port. The port will not be available unless you have Scramble on. And here is where you can choose whether you want to dock your VPN to the taskbar or not. And that's really it, really. Another cool thing is that you can actually send them the logs. So if you're having trouble with the VPN, you can send crash reports and send them the diagnostics here in order for them or for the Provado VPN team to help you with any kind of troubleshooting. So that's really it. There's not much with Provado VPN besides being really just one of the best VPNs, one of the best free VPNs you could use. Now, suppose you, let's say, want an actual VPN, because free VPNs won't be able to give you the ability to, let's say, unblock Netflix and get the true potential out of VPNs, really, especially if you're trying to unblock streaming services. You're not going to be able to do that with Provado VPN, and you won't have access to some of the other features, even with the paid version with Provado VPN, really. So if you're looking for a good free VPN, of course, Provado VPN is probably one of the best out there. But if you're trying to, let's say, pay for a VPN, then I would recommend ExpressVPN, NordVPN, or Surfshark. These are some of the best VPNs you'll find in the market today, solely because, really, when it comes to any kind of functionality or whatever you're trying to do using a VPN, be it securing your data while on public Wi-Fi, securing your torrenting client in order to keep yourself protected, using it for streaming services, to unblock streaming services, be it Netflix, HBO, or any of the popular streaming services. All of these VPNs are able to do all of these tasks within their different limited capacities, let's say. So it depends. With regards to Netflix, for example, using it as a reference, ExpressVPN will be able to unblock up to 18 libraries, 10 with Nord, and 15 libraries with Surfshark. Of course, these are the confirmed libraries as told by the live chat support of ExpressVPN or VPN or Surfshark. So you can do your own testing, actually, and possibly unlock even more libraries. But these are the confirmed libraries. Of course, all these VPNs have the basic functionality of the network lock or the kill switch and split tunneling. The kill switch will stop all internet traffic when the VPN disconnects unexpectedly. And the split tunneling will let you choose which apps go through the VPN connection and which don't. So this could be useful when you just want your, let's say, VPN to affect your torrenting client and nothing else, or Netflix, for example. So we have, of course, unlike Provado VPN, you have a handful of protocols. And when it comes to speed, it will be much more secure and speedy. All these VPNs will definitely offer much more security, privacy, better no-log policy, and faster speeds. So in conclusion, let's say you want to just make an investment in one of these paid VPNs. Now, just keep in mind, they all do have 30-day money-back guarantees on all of their plans, so you're able to actually try it out for free for 30 days and get your refund before the 30th day. Another cool thing, actually, is ExpressVPN and Surfshark offer a full 7-day free trial on the Android and iOS devices. So if you're looking to try them out for free, you can do that on these devices. Nord does not offer that, unfortunately. In conclusion, if you're looking for the best security, best speed, especially if you may be in censorship heavy countries, ExpressVPN will be your choice, the best choice, really. That's what I personally use. I'm not in a censorship heavy country, but I do use my VPN for the most part for streaming services. So ExpressVPN is my go-to, since it is able to unblock the biggest number of streaming services and Netflix libraries, having 94 countries, unlike NordVPN's 60 countries and Surfshark's 65 countries. Now, if you're looking for a VPN that gives you 4 different types of specialty servers, an ad blocker, the powerful NordLynx protocol, an app kill switch, which will disconnect or terminate selected applications, actually more like close the selected applications when the VPN disconnects unexpectedly rather than terminating the entire connection. You've got, of course, split tunneling, custom DNS servers, or an easy way actually to change your DNS rather than having to fiddle with your Windows. Obfuscated servers will help you bypass the Great Firewall of China if you're in China, for example, and that's only meant to be used with OpenVPN TCP and only if the regular servers aren't working. Most of the times, though, it really does work quite a bit well without having to use obfuscated servers. And the NordLynx protocol, as I mentioned earlier, it makes NordVPN the fastest VPN in the market today. That is it, really. And by the way, when you switch to NordLynx, you lose access to double VPN and a dedicated IP. So yeah, and NordVPN has 60 countries and over 5,300 servers, and it will let you secure up to 6 devices, unlike ExpressVPN's 5 devices. So you'll be losing out on a little bit of streaming capabilities, but you'll be getting speed and a whole bunch of, let's say, extra features. Now, if you're looking for the cheapest VPN to get the job done while maintaining the quality and speed, perhaps losing out on a little bit of functionality in censorship-heavy countries and a little bit of security and speed that is below NordVPN. And when it comes to ExpressVPN and Surfshark, they're roughly the same speed. It's just that ExpressVPN is able to unblock more streaming services and is much more secure. But that does not mean that NordVPN or Surfshark are not secure or fast. They're still fast enough. It's just that Surfshark is meant to be the budget VPN that still gives you plenty of features such as multi-hop, which is double VPN, and static IP, which is dedicated IP, like in NordVPN. You get over 3,200 servers in 60 countries, as I mentioned, and you do still get the split tunneling, kill switch, Clean Web, which is an ad blocker, as well as the powerful WireGuard protocol and a Shadow Socks protocol, which is not available in neither Nord nor ExpressVPN, which will help you reach banned websites if you're in a censorship-heavy country. No Borders Mode will help you bypass the Great Firewall of China if you're in China. So overall, these VPNs are just great. And by the way, Surfshark, I haven't mentioned yet. I nearly forgot to mention it, but perhaps this is the biggest selling point of Surfshark, is that it will allow you to secure an unlimited amount of devices with just one subscription that barely costs $60 for two entire years. So that is one of the biggest selling points for sure, because if you're looking to unblock or secure an unlimited amount of devices with NordVPN and ExpressVPN, you would need to get yourself a compatible router and install these VPNs on a router. By the way, ExpressVPN's router app is one of the easiest to use. Requires little to no configuration, but you will need to get a compatible router. And some of these routers can be a little bit costly, nearly $100, $200, depending on the quality of the router you're getting. So that'll be it for this video. Again, if you guys are interested in any of the VPNs mentioned today, be it ExpressVPN, NordVPN, or Surfshark, you'll find links to special deals and discounts in the description down below. That includes Provado, by the way, as well as reviews if you'd like to know the ins and outs of these VPNs. Thank you guys very much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. Have a wonderful day.